Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. I have started a new video series on building a real-time data analysis system. Okay, so in this video I am going to discuss about the next component in the installation, which is part of our environment setup. Okay, which is actually the component called Apache Superset, which is the one of the coolest visualization framework okay, I've used in this project. Okay, so let's discuss how to install it. Okay, so before going to the Apache Superset visualization framework, Apache Superset actually supports from the Python 3.6. okay, so you need to install Python 3.6 or later version. So I prefer to use Python 3.7, which is the latest version. So we'll start with installing Python 3.7, then we'll install Superset, and also I have a videos to install setting up the PyCharm environment to run the PySpark code. You can follow it. I will add the videos in my videos description. Okay. Now we'll start with the Python Anaconda distribution of Python version 3.7, and followed by Apache Superset. Okay, let's start. Okay, so first thing is you can just Google the Apache Anaconda Python distribution. Once you Google it, you can just first link itself will come Anaconda Python. Then open this, click on this download button. Go to the home page of the Anaconda website and click on the download button. Then it will come to the download page. You can actually scroll down a little bit, and you can find out three tab which says whether you want to download the installer for Windows or Mac OS or Linux. So I'm installing all this this entire project in Ubuntu 18.04. So I'm going to get the installer for the 3.7 installed for the Linux operating system, which is Ubuntu. So once you click on this download button, it is going to download the installer. Okay, it's around 586 MB of data. So based on your internet connectivity, it will be slower or faster. Okay, once you download this, so it by default, it will, for me, I'm using a broadband, so it will download it within few seconds or few minutes. So once you download it, you can just open this. It will be downloaded by default in downloads folder. This is the binary file or the installer file. Anaconda 3-2019.10-linux-x86-64.sh. This is the installer file. Take this and put it on your wherever the location you want to install. Actually, I am putting all my softwares in my software folder. So I just placed it here. Okay, now what you need to do is basically to install this Anaconda installer, you need to convert actually with the check the data integrity or the installer integrity using a SHA-256 sum. So you get to check the installer's integrity. So once it is, you get this extra kind of GUID kind of alphanumeric kind of word, big word. It's good, actually your installer is good. Now we can start the installation by running this sh command. So you can use the bash command, bash space followed by the installer full file name, because I'm running from the same location where this file is located. So otherwise you can give the path. So once you run this, it will ask you to whether you want to continue the installation process. If you want to say yes, just enter, click on enter, and it will going to show you some of the license agreement, user license agreement. Just click on yes. It will keep on pressing enter. So it will prompt you saying that, do you accept the license terms? Say yes, yes. After that, it will ask you where you want to install it. Basically, by default, it will try to install your user's home directory. You can prefer to, if you want to change it to different location, you can just provide the location, or just enter for just to continue with the default location. I'm just continuing with the default location. So then it will start installing the required packages. So Anaconda, it will install the Anaconda distribution, Python distribution 3.7, as well as it will install some of the basics packages by default. Okay, so it is installing. Okay, after that it says, do you want to basically do you wish to install the wish to installer to initialize the Anaconda by running a conda in it? Yes, I say continue. So when I say yes, it will go to add this initialize the conda environment. Okay, so after that basically you can go to the bashrc file. Actually you can just add your check your whether the installation location is added in your environment variable. If not, you can just go to add the path in your path variable in the bashrc file, and then refresh the bashrc file using a source command. So then your Python installation is done. To verify that, just type Python. So it will show you what version of Python is installed. So it is Python 3.7.4, and it's Anaconda distribution of Python. Okay. So that's all, friends. So this is with respect to Python installation is done. Now we'll start with the very important component called Superset. Okay, it's a visualization framework. Okay, so to install that, you can actually go to the Google and type Apache Superset. It's a incubating project which is recently added in the Apache Foundation as an incubation project. So just Google it, Apache Superset. The first link itself will come. Just open it and click on this installation and configuration link. So it is going to open this. Just scroll down. There are some basic before installing the Superset, you need to install the few dependency packages or libraries. Okay, so just come to this OS dependencies. So I'm using a Ubuntu version. So there is a apt-get install for different libraries. Just copy this in your terminal and install it. Okay, so it is going to take around 181 MB of data. Just say yes. Then it is going to install the dependency libraries or packages. Once it is done, so if you are using both the Python 2.7 as well as 3.6 or later, there are other dependencies you need to install. So that it's already given here. Just copy paste this and install this. Once you install this, then you need to actually, what they are saying is they are suggesting to create a virtual environment in Python virtual environment, and it's one of the recommendation Superset community gives, like you create a Python virtual environment, then install the Superset on top of that, then it is good actually. So we are going to create the virtual environment. Just checking the Python the conda version. Conda is nothing but a kind of installer, a package installer in Anaconda distribution like pip. Okay, so just checking the version. So it is taking from Python 3 which we installed. Now I try to update, it's already latest only. Now you can create a virtual environment. So basically to command is conda create space -n the name of the virtual environment. My virtual environment is venv superset space, what is the version of Python, Python equal to 3.7 and followed by Anaconda distribution. So it is going to install the all the packages like how we do the normal installation, right? It's going to as a separate environment. So say yes, it is going to do all the stuff, downloading the package and extracting it, and then it is created, the virtual environment is created, and it says to activate, there is a command conda space activate. Then give the virtual environment name, which is the venv superset. If you want to deactivate the environment, then there's another command called conda space deactivate. It will get deactivated. Okay, so first activate it. Once you come there, now you can just if you want, you can upgrade the pip package. So just run this, it's upgraded. Now time to install the superset. This is a Python package, right? So just pip install, give the superset. It's going to install all the superset libraries or packages, dependency packages, everything. So let's see, all is installed successfully. Installed a Flask a Babel, Flask Jart, and a Flask OpenID, Flask SQL Alchemy. So This Apache Superset is basically is built based on the Python, okay, Python and Flask application and SQL Alchemy. There are various Flask, Python based packages it is using. So it's all, everything is installed properly. Now we can actually upgrade the database. Okay, so Superset uses some default database to maintain some of the metadata. So just upgrade it. So once upgrade is completed, basically you can just export this Flask application. So this is built based on the Python, right? Python Flask. So just export this Flask app equal to Superset. So once this is created, just create the account. Okay, so basically you can create a admin account and other accounts. So first you need to create admin account. So just run this command flask space fab space create hyphen admin. So it is going to create so basically it's going to prompt you to enter the username, which is admin, and first name, last name. So I just given administrator as a first name, last name is a data making, it's my final name, and I given the mail id as data making.india@gmail.com, and provide the password and repeat the password for confirmation. So once it is created, it is going to say administrator user admin is created. That's it, we have done with the user creation. Then you can actually load the actually Superset comes with some example samples dashboards. So all these examples and sample data are kept in this folder or package. You just load that. Okay, so once you say Superset space load underscore example, it's going to load it. It's going to upload the tables, other stuff. So once this is done, now it's time to initialize the Superset. In Superset space init, it's going to initialize this. Once the initialization is done, now it's time to run your Superset application and explore that how to build the dashboard and for your application. Okay, so what is the command you need to run? Superset space run. It's like running your Flask based application. So Superset space run space p port number, you are giving 8080. You can give different port if you want to put it, and the withdraws and reload and debugger options, all the stuff. So once you run this, it is going to launch your application on 8080 port, the Flask application, which is a Superset. Okay, so it is going to launch it. So you can just take this URL and open this. So this is the login page of the Superset application or the dash framework. Okay, so you can just give the login. You already created the administrator login and password, right? It's ready password. Just give the user ID and password. So my user is admin, just given the password. This is the home page of the Apache Superset. Now the you can create there are security options available. There are sources, different sources you can access, different data RDBMS data sources and different data sources it supports, and you can create a charts. Once you create a lot of charts, you can build the dashboard, and also they provide a SQL kind of editor to run your query on the data source you connect. It's very useful and very good actually, the open source visualization software. I was looking for lot of times I was trying to search for any open source visualization software is there. Recently I found through one of the Quorum post. Thank you for them actually posting there. So it's good. Now we installed the Superset the component or the library. Now it's time to start our setting up our Kafka producer and streaming application and run our application and just see the data in the we build the dashboard and see the data in the dashboard. Okay, so that's it. Installation and environment setup is done. Next we'll actually continue on the explaining about each application, like the Kafka producer application is there and streaming application is there. But how we are going to set up the table design for MySQL and Cassandra, all thing I'm going to explain in the coming up videos. Thank you so much, friends. See you in the next video.